I've never done anything like this before.
This is always the weird part.
So strange.
You know, I'm not a TV host or anything, so it's kind of awkward. You guys are gonna make history. And I cried so much.
Me too.
Hi Vogue, it's Jessica Jung, and today I'm going to be speaking with three artists that are currently on my playlist. Daniel Caesar,
yeah, you know what? Yes.
Division, and Ravina.
It's kind of like that.
I love their music and their next up and coming artists. I have so many things to say, oh my god. Hi Daniel.
Hi Jessica, how are you doing?
It's so nice to meet you. So Daniel, can you introduce yourself to the Vogue audience?
My name is Daniel Caesar and I sing songs. I've been
the best songs.
Oh man, thank you. Thank you. You don't know, babe,
where you hold me. How did this all start for you?
I could always kind of sing. That was always what I would do.
So you're a natural.
Yeah. Yeah, and also just, yeah, in the church and stuff like that.
I would have loved to go to that church.
Man, I was up there shaking and scared, but it was fun.
I wasn't really a natural like you. I was scouted when I was 11. I trained for 7 years. So I did all the singing lessons, dancing lessons, and
almost like engineered to be superstars.
I guess it kind of is, yeah.
I'm curious, like tell me more about that.
Yeah, it's kind of like a private school. You know what I'm saying?
It's a lot more like strict over there. Like you guys like no alcohol or their promiscuity, like none of that, eh?
There's like a no dating rule, no messaging, no emails. Like for years, it was just like, you know, I had to go to the office and call my mom.
Do they ever explain their reasoning or it's kind of just like...
I guess they wanted you like in the zone. You've been here, right?
Korea is always one of my favorite spots. Soju, we drink a lot of soju.
Oh, you drink soju?
Yeah. What's that thing you guys do when you like you take your two fingers and like hit the cap off or something like that?
That takes some skills though. Your like personal style and like your writing skills. And
as far as musical influences growing up, it was a lot of Stevie Wonder and Boys to Men, Kirk Franklin.
Because you mentioned Boys to Men, I went to their concert in Vegas and I cried so much watching it.
That was sort of amazing.
And I'm probably gonna cry when I see you sing too.
Oh man.
Yeah, I'm a very emotional person. So out of all your songs, and you had to pick one favorite, what would it be?
Best part, Entropy. Best part, Entropy. Get you, let's go get you.
I mean, I knew it was gonna be hard for you.
You were right?
Anyway, thank you for your time, and thank you for joining me today, Daniel. I had so much fun.
And for real, and like next time I'm in California, you gotta come to a show, you gotta link up.
I can definitely have some soju with you.
Oh, let's do it. Bye.
Thank you. So I started my career when I was scouted when I was 11. I trained for 7 years and my debut album was when I was 18 with a girl band. My dream was never to become a singer. As a trainee, like when I took vocal lessons, most of the songs that I listened to and were learning to sing was R&B. Artists like Mariah Carey, Whitney Houston. I felt like, wow, I want to sing that kind of song. It really inspired me to become a singer. Hi guys, hi.
How's it going?
Thank you for joining me.
Thanks for having us. How did you discover us?
My sister actually.
Thank you, sister.
Like, she loved your music and then I listened to it and it was like, just perfect. I will make your whole body smile. And I know. How would you guys describe the Division sound?
Constantly evolving.
Constantly evolving, I love that.
Yeah, I, the one thing with Division is, absolutely, we're rooted in R&B, but we always want to find a way to shock people and to throw different elements into things. The one thing I want to be known for when it's all said and done is that as soon as you think you know what to expect from us, you're going to get surprised.
What were your biggest, like, influences?
You know, the Michael Jacksons, the Stevie Wonders, the Jay-Z's, all the people that laid these foundations of like legendary music that you can listen to now and still listen to, you know, 10 years from now, 20 years from now.
But it's not easy to have a song that after a year or even after a couple months, people want to listen to again.
And I think it's getting worse now in a sense, because it's like we're in so much of like a binge culture. We've always tried to, you know, try to make music that we felt like could push through that.
You guys are going to make history.
Hope so, hopefully, God willing, God willing.
I think this is also the first album we've had that has so many songs that work in like crowd settings.
Social gathering.
Look what you made me do. Ooh.
It's your turn.
Look what you made me do.
Sing.
What I like about it is the fact that a lot of people, you know, have whether messaged or commented or DM'd or, you know, spoken about it and kind of said that this helped them get through it. So, you know, for us, it was like, okay, you know, we did something right, at least. If this wasn't for us, it's just for you guys, you know?
Awesome. I was waiting for it too, so thank you for releasing it. I think you guys have like a really huge fan base here. We love your music.
You know what is BTS from there?
Yes.
I don't know if it's the main singer. One of them is a fan, and I don't remember his name, forgive me, but definitely shout out to them. I've seen them tweet out the music and big out the music.
That's cool. Anyways, I hope to see you guys soon, and maybe we can do something together in the future.
No, we gotta make that happen, that's for sure.
Yeah, thank you for joining me.
All right, cool, thank you. Thanks for having me.
All right, bye guys. I recently released my first fiction novel. It follows a young Korean-American girl who moves to Seoul at a young age and trains 24/7 for her chance to shine. In Korea, when I came here, I was a bit homesick. I missed my friends. I missed, you know, just the fast food, the mall, the freedom. So it was a learning process for me, but I guess I was young and I could adjust. I kind of tackled it one by one and kind of got to where I wanted to be. Hi, Ravina.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good.
I love your voice.
Aww, thank you.
It's just so enchanting.
When I was younger and I didn't know better.
Out of all your songs that you've written, if you would have to pick one song to tell the Vogue audience to listen to, what would it be?
I think it would be Petal. I don't know if too many people know that song because it's literally like the outro of Lucid. And I think it's one of my favorite things I've ever made. So I would say listen to Petal and watch the video.
You know, I hate to put you on the spot, but can you like sing us a little tune?
A Petal?
Yeah.
When I feel like a petal floating through the breeze. When I feel like I spent a lot of my teens and early 20s in a really confused and anxious and depressed state. A lot of my music is about healing and about the journey of just like becoming a better human being, a more in touch human being.
I sense that because your music is very calm and soothing.
Yeah, a lot of it is, but I think I have a lot more sides to express because I'm of course like drawn to that energy, but you know, I can definitely be a bit chaotic at times too, so. I'm excited for people to see more of that side.
So do you have plans for 2021, like new music or new collaborations? Or?
Definitely new music. I can't say much, but I am working on a lot of new music, new visuals right now, and kind of entering in a new like era of my art right now, and it's really exciting, and I hope to share some of it in 2021. I don't want to make any promises, but
I can't wait.
Yeah, it's gonna be good.
Yeah. you're so talented. Thank you for joining me.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Thank you. I definitely wanted to introduce to you guys these three artists. I love their music, and they're always on my playlist, and you should definitely take a listen. Hi Vogue, I'm Jessica Jung, and to watch more videos, subscribe here.